Good afternoon and welcome to this presentation. SwissDOTS mini future, today's agenda, definition, glossary, practical application with a real example, term sheet, pros and cons, platform, and how to send order with a Swissquote. This is me, I'm Stefano Gianti, Education Manager for the Swissquote Bank. In case you want to drop me an email for questions, please do not hesitate to write at stefano.gianti@swissquote.com. If you need more information about our trading services, this is the number that you have to dial, or visit swissquote.com. We also have a chat feature on our website. Of course, this is the disclaimer. The content of all our webinars is always purely informative and does not constitute an offer or a recommendation for any legal decision, and is not to be understood as advice. What is the SwissDOTS? We already had different webinars on the topic, specifically one for each single product category, that are warrants, no-cut warrants, mini future today, and factor certificate. You can trade SwissDOTS products with a flat rate from just 9 Swiss franc. And the SwissDOTS universe comprises over 90,000 derivatives with various underlying, including equities, indices, commodities, and currency pair, and also cryptocurrencies. What are the benefits? There are attractive spreads and extended trading hours. You can trade from 8 a.m. to 10 p.m. Central European time. You can trade a wide range of products that we already listed. So you find more than 90,000 products in 4 categories: warrants, no-cut warrants, mini future, and factor certificate. At your disposal for learning, we have a blog with named Swissquote Education, with a section dedicated to SwissDOTS. So if you have the PDF of this presentation, I will add the link in the YouTube video, so you can click below. You can access to all of these videos and ebooks and previous video that we already produce, and other webinars on SwissDOTS, where we explain what is a warrant, what is a no-cut warrant, and now what is a mini future. So the peculiarity of this product and the differences are listed here. Mini future benefit of variable leverage. They don't have volatility effect, so the pricing is much easier to understand respect to warrants, because there is no time decay, there is no volatility effect. There is no maturity, so there is no unexpiry date, as it happened for warrants. And there is a built-in mechanism that is a stop loss. So if the stop loss level will be touched, there will be an premature expiry of the contract, but this is what we're going to investigate further in the next minutes. Mini future. Let's start, of course, with the definition. Mini future are securities that allow an investor to gain returns in a rising market if you buy a long mini future, or a declining market in case you buy a short mini future. The underlying asset may be equities, stock indices, commodities, or currencies. Just like warrants and no-cut warrants, any return is paid out in cash. So there is a cash settlement. There is never the physical delivery of the underlying asset. A mini future consists of two elements: the capital invested by the investor and the loan offered by the issuer. Mini futures are typically open-end securities, which means that they don't have an expiry date and hence have no time value. And this is the reason why they are different from options and warrant. And the mini future pricing is pretty straightforward and easy to understand, since there is no time decay and volatility included in the formula, in the pricing. So this is what we said: since there is no time value, the valuation is relatively simple. The value of a mini future is based on the difference between the capital invested and the loan offered by the issuer. Okay, so this is what we already told, just to recap. okay, adjust with a multiplier. Of course, with the example that we are going to make, it will be pretty easy and straightforward to understand in minutes. Also, if you are a future trader, this is a good comparison. Okay, so for some of you, this slide is only for some of you that maybe already have experience in derivative products trading future. A future contract is a standardized legal agreement to buy or sell an underlying security at a predetermined price at a specific time in the future. The first future contract were negotiated for agricultural commodities, and the original use of future contract was to mitigate the risk of price or exchange rate movements by allowing parties to fix prices or rates in advance or for future transaction. Okay, but let's say that most of the time future contract also offer the opportunity for speculation. Okay, so if I think the market will go up, I buy a future. If I think the market will go down, I sell a future. Okay, I open a short position on the future. Future contracts have standard terms defined by the exchange, such as Chicago Mercantile Exchange or Eurex. For mini future, this is one of the biggest difference. Since there is in the mini future a built-in stop loss mechanism, there is no margin requirement. So if you trade future, already know that if you buy a future, if you buy or sell a future, there is a margin requirement from the exchange, from the broker. Okay, since there is this big difference for mini future trader, so there is a built-in stop loss mechanism, there is no margin requirement for mini future. Okay, so this is the biggest difference. So the main two difference between future and mini future is, first, future are standardized contract and you can trade future on the exchange, Chicago Mercantile Exchange or Eurex. You trade mini future directly with the issuer, because with SwissDOTS you trade directly with the issuer. Okay, the second big difference is that for future there is a margin requirement. For mini future, this is not the case. There is no margin requirement since there is this built-in stop loss mechanism. Okay, the mini future, as I said, are created and managed by the issuer that is also the market maker, and you find here the list of our partners for SwissDOTS. So these are the issuer and market makers of the products. Okay, so we close a chapter dedicated to comparison future and mini future. Also, if you watch our second webinar of this series dedicated to SwissDOTS, we talk about knockout warrants, and knockout warrants are a very similar product compared to mini future. The difference is that knockout warrant have a strike price equal to the stop loss, while mini future have a strike price that is called financing level different, so not equal, different from the stop loss. This is the biggest difference between knockout warrants and mini future. Okay, so this slide is only for people that already follow our webinars and video about SwissDOTS. If the stop loss level is hit for the knockout warrant, the contract expires worthless without any value, while the mini future has a residual value that will be the difference between the financing level and the stop loss, but we will investigate further in the next minutes. And then glossary. So the expression that you need to know if you are a mini future trader. So the underlying, as we said, can be equity, currency, stock indices, or commodities. Financing level, a mini future contains a loan that finances the difference between the invested capital and the price of the underlying asset. So it's like that the issuer is providing you a loan. Okay, the loan is called financing level. Okay, you pay the interest on the loan through the addition of the interest to the mini future financing level on a daily basis. This is important, and this is a way to understand the mini future. So it is true that there is a loan. You don't pay this loan on a daily basis with a commission debited on your trading account, but there is a financing level and stop loss level adjustment over the time. Okay, so let's say that the financing level is changing day by day, and this is a way not to let you pay a fixed commission when you open the position on or on a daily basis. Okay, stop loss. Mini futures have a built-in stop loss level which limits the negative value development of the product. If the underlying reaches the stop loss level, the mini future expires immediately with a residual value. Okay, this value, the settlement value or residual value, will be paid out in cash on your trading account by the issuer. Please bear in mind that just in case the financing level and the stop loss level that they will be equal to zero, the paid out in cash will be equal to zero as well. But let's say that most of the time there is this residual value. This is the biggest difference between the knockout warrants and mini future that we said before. There is no residual value for knockout warrants. There is a residual value for mini future. That is the difference between the two products. Intrinsic value, if you are an option trader, a future trader, or a warrant trader, you already know that the intrinsic value is simply the difference between the underlying current market price and the strike price. That for mini future, this term strike is also known as financing level. Okay, so this is the intrinsic value, the difference between the underlying asset price and the mini future strike price that you select, because you have the possibility to select the strike price that you wish. What is the ratio? This term is also known as multiplier, or sometimes you can find conversion ratio, but in our platform is simply ratio. The ratio indicates the number of mini future needed to buy or sell one unit of the underlying products. For example, a long mini future with a ratio 10 means that the holder needs 10 mini future to purchase one share. Okay. Open end. Open end simply means that there is no expiry date. Okay. There is no expiry date for the mini futures. In this case, you see in the slide knockout warrants, because also for the knockout warrants, there is no expiry date, but also for mini future, there is no expiry date. Okay. So it's important to know that you can open the position when you want, you will close the position when you want, also intraday, no problem. So the position will be closed when you decide to close the position, selling your long position, or when the event, the stop loss level will occur. Okay, so two possibilities to close the position, or you close by yourself, or in the future, first or later, maybe, the stop loss level will be hit and the issuer in this case will close the position for you. Leverage for all the derivative products. Leverage is the difference, leverage is the leverage effect of a mini future. The greater the leverage, the more speculative the investment instrument. Leverage of 5 means if the underlying security rises 1%, the warrant price rises 5%, for example. Or the same way, if the underlying security lose 1%, the warrant lose 5%, the warrant of the mini future, okay? All the derivative products. How to calculate leverage for a mini future? This is the formula. Price of the underlying instrument divided by the mini future market price divided by the ratio. This is an example, but now we are going directly to the different examples. So you see the formula is extremely easy. Practical application for a long mini future. Let's start with the long position that is always much familiar and easy to understand. So we have two investors that have the same view on the stock. So the stock, Jack, but also Simon, we have the two traders, that use two different products, but they have a common view. So the stock will, the stock price will go up, okay, will rise. So Jack is going to buy 100 of our stocks, for example, this is the price, and of course, this is the investment, okay? Stock price times 100 stock. Jack also decides to place a stop loss at this level. So the risk is the difference between the entry price and the stop loss price. Please bear in mind that a stop loss order is designed to limit an investor loss on a security position that makes an unfavorable move. So the investment is more than 8,000 Swiss franc, but the risk is 923, because it's the difference between the entry price and eventually the stop loss if the position goes in the wrong direction. Then there is another trader, that is Simon, that has the same view as Jack, since he thinks that the stock will increase in value, but he's not going to buy stock. He wants to use leverage, and he decides to trade mini future, buying 1,000 mini future. Why 1,000? Simply because is the ratio is 10. So instead of buying 100 stock, you have to buy 100 times the ratio, that is 1,000, of course. Okay. And then this is extremely important. When you buy a mini future, you select the strike price, the stop loss, okay? The stop loss in this case, not strike price. The strike price is the financing level. In this case, we're talking about stop loss. So stop loss is this one, okay? And the price, the market price of this moment of the mini future is 117. So the investment is 1,170. That is, you see, 7 times lower than Jack investment, okay? So this is a recap. Jack, the value of the investment, the risk, and Simon, the value of the investment and the risk. These are the information that you see from our platform. If you trade mini future, you have several information. In the left corner, you see the underlying security, the name. In the right corner, you see the underlying current market price, in this case 82.81. okay, and then a lot of information about the mini future, for example, the volume, the 1 year high, 1 year low, 2 days high and 2 days low, plus of course the last price and the bid and the ask price, 119 at the moment. Okay, and this is important. You have to focus your attention here now. So the ratio is 10, and the financing level, that is different from the stop loss level. Please remember that the strike price is the financing level, 17.11 at the moment, and the stop loss is 72.59. The stop loss is extremely important, because if this level will be hit, since your position is open, the mini future expires immediately with a residual value. The residual value will be the difference between the financing level and the stop loss of that day, okay? So today, these are the financing level and the stop loss. Tomorrow will be something a little bit different, okay? Then I also show you the term sheet where there are also more information about this calculation, but this is straightforward information. So you have the financing level and the stop loss here in the platform. How to calculate the theoretical value of a long mini future, the price of the underlying security, less the financing level of the mini future, and the result is divided by the ratio, that is 10. Okay, so you find 82.81 minus 71.11, the result divided by 10, 1.17. Okay, it is important that you are aware how to calculate the theoretical value. Maybe sometimes you can also find opportunities, or you decide to place the your buy limit to buy the mini future, or you at this level, or you will just check if the pricing of the issuer in this moment is correct according to this formula. Okay. What are the three different scenarios for Jack and Simon? So let's start with the scenario number one. Stock price rises 10%, and of course Jack profit is 10%. Okay, so he decides to sell his stock at 90, making a profit of 818 Swiss francs. More or less the same for Simon, since he has a mini future. He will sell it at market price, that will be 1.988, this is my calculation, and the profit is the same. So you see, in terms of amount of money, in terms of Swiss franc, the profit is the same. Of course, it's different in percentage because the investment is different between the two traders, but the just to show this slide that the profit, the profitability in terms of Swiss franc in amount, I mean in money, is the same. Then, of course, scenario number two, if there is not a movement and after some days the stock price is always there, the profit or loss is always zero for Jack and Simon. But please bear in mind that Simon, the financing level will change over the time, a little bit daily, day after day, okay? Worst scenario is that stock price falls, hitting the stop loss, so Jack will close his position at the stop loss level, 72.59, as we said before, losing 923 Swiss franc, that is 11% of the investment. What will happen on Simon account? Exactly will happen this, that the mini future will expire. Okay, boom, price hit, stop loss hit, the mini future will expire, so you cannot trade anymore, and the issuer will credit on your trading account the difference between the financing level and the stop loss of the day, so you have a residual value that is impossible to calculate before. So to keep it simple, I'm put here in this slide the same amount that Jack lost, but will change over the time, okay? Because if you have a long position, the financing level will be a little bit higher day after day, okay? But what really happen on your trading account is that the mini future expires immediately, and then the issuer will credit on your trading account the residual value of the mini future. Okay. This is the same information with the percentage. So for scenario one, for Jack, the profit is 10%. For Simon, is 70%, simply because he's using the leverage effect, is using the mini future. Okay. And the same for the loss. In terms of percentage, the loss is 7 times higher. Okay, so in terms of amount, the loss or the profit is the same. In terms of percentage, is 7 times bigger. Simply because he's investing, Simon is investing less and using the leverage of the mini future. Okay, let's switch to another example, practical application, short mini future. Alfred, let's use another trader, thinks that there will be a price retracement of the SMI index in the coming days, so he's considering to open a bearish trade. So he's going to buy a short mini future, in this case 100 short mini future. I use this low amount, 300 Swiss franc, also to explain that you can trade future, mini future, with a small amount, because if you trade future, the margin requirement is much higher. If you trade mini future, you choose. So if you want to buy a mini future, one mini future at 3 Swiss franc, potentially you can do. Of course, then there is the commission of 9 francs to pay. So in this case, will be not convenient. But just to show you that in case you can buy as low as one mini future. that is the amount is 100 times smaller than the future on the SME. Okay, so just to also explain why there is this name mini future, because it's mini, it's smaller, the size is smaller compared to a standard future contract. Okay, this is the data table, the mini future chain we want to call. So you can select the strike price. Remember that strike price for mini future is the financing level. You see, this is the financing level that is different from the stop loss, and the financing level changes day by day. And then you have the same information that we showed before, the underlying name on the left, the underlying price at the right, and then information about the mini future product. So the high of the year, the low of the year, the high of the day, and the low of the day. The last price, bid ask price. The ask price is the price that you, if you want to buy at market, you buy at the ask price 306 in this moment. Okay, let's calculate the leverage. Okay, for this reason, I select in this case, for this example, a strike price that is very, very near to the current underlying security market price. You see the difference between the financing level and the price of the security on the SME index is only 300 points. Okay, 300 points only in this case. So it's very near in terms of percentage, is nothing. Okay, so this is how to calculate the leverage, the price of the underlying security divided by the price of the mini future. And the result is divided by the ratio. Okay, in this case, the leverage effect is pretty high. The previous example with Novartis was 7, now on the SME is 31. But simply because I selected a strike that is very near to the current market price of the underlying security, just to show that you can really select the leverage that you wish. For example, if you want to select something else, so leverage 31 is too high. Let's go on the platform, so SwissQuote.com, and then Markets and Quotes, or SwissQuote CH. Then you select SwissDOTS here on the left, and then you can filter your search. In this case, I want to trade the SME index. I want to trade mini future. Okay, and in this case, I want to open long position or short position, or all you can select from here. In case, you can also filter, for example, the stop loss. Okay, if you want stop loss from until. Okay, and now we have 248 results. I go just to show you to the last one, so page 9, selecting the farthest one. Okay, this will be the strike, so far away. And now let's calculate together the leverage of this other product. Okay, so underlying security in the upper in the right, you see here. Okay, divided by the price, 40.62, the ask price of the mini future. This mini future is more expensive since the stop loss level is far away, so is more expensive respect to the previous one. And then we have to divide for the ratio that is 100. So in this case, the leverage of this other mini future is 2.4, so 2 instead of 31, just to show you that you can really select the leverage that you want. In this case, in this example, is 31, simply because the financing level is only 300 index point from the current market price. In this other case, is 3,000 points. So the leverage effect is much more smaller, is 2 instead of 31. So you see the difference. You select the leverage that you want. Also, for this reason, it's important that you are able to calculate for yourself the leverage. Okay, remember, the nearer the strike, the highest the leverage. Another information about the dividends. Mini future mirrors the performance of the underlying asset almost perfectly. The exception is for dividends. In this case, there is a strike price adjustment. The strike price is the financing level, same name. Okay, different name, but same thing. Whoever has a long position does not receive a dividend, and whoever has a short position does not pay it. Okay, because bear in mind that if you have a stock, you have a long position, you receive the dividend. With the mini future, you don't receive the dividend, but there is a financing level price adjustment in your favor. Okay? And then, of course, talking about leverage, the closer the financing level, that is the strike, the higher the leverage. Term sheet example. Always, please, 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 always read the term sheet before opening a new trade. You find the term sheet in the upper left of this table. This is an example, and in this example, please notice that there are several information about the interest rate per annum for the adjustment. Okay, so how moves the financial level over the time. There is this information that is 2.25%. And then there is also the adjustment percentage for the first adjustment period that is 1.45%. So you find all the information regarding the product itself. Okay? Please remember that knockout warrants, we talk about in another webinar, and mini future are under the category of turbo warrants. So in the term sheet, sometimes you find this name turbo warrants. This is the category, okay? And also the stop loss level is knockout event. So this is the glossary, the jargon. And another information is, for example, the leverage at issue. So I show you how to calculate the leverage now with this pricing of the underlying security and the mini future market price. But there is also here in the term sheet the leverage at issue that then, of course, change over the time. Pros and cons of the instrument. Relatively low capital commitment, limited losses, potential of exceptional returns, easy to understand pricing because there is only intrinsic value and no time and volatility value as it happens for warrants. Good for hedging your existing position. This is a very important point because a common usage of derivatives in general is that maybe you have already different long positions in your portfolio. So maybe you are long on Novartis, long on the SME, long on the DAX, long on Ripple, long on the euro dollar, on Tesla, I don't know. And for some reason, you want to hedge this position. Maybe because you think that in the next days, the market will fall. So you buy a mini future short to hedge your existing position. Or maybe you have a stock because you need to take the dividends. You want to hedge the bearish exposure. So you buy a short mini future. Okay, so the first use of all the derivatives is to hedge the portfolio. The second use of derivatives is to speculate on the pricing. Okay, so consider in case to open a position on mini future to hedge your existing portfolio. Okay. And then, as I explained before, the biggest difference between futures and mini future is that for mini future, there is no margin requirement since they have this built-in stop loss mechanism. What about the cons? Mini futures are vulnerable in volatile markets. So if there is a fast market movement, if there is a important news, there is an event, and there is a huge movement, it is very likely that the stop loss will be hit and the mini future will expire. So remember that if the stop loss level has been occurred, it expires immediately with a residual value that sometimes can be zero. If the financing level in that moment is equal to the stop loss, in that case only the residual value will be equal to zero. But remember that the standard procedure is that if the event occurs, so if there is the stop loss level hit, the mini future expires, and then the issuer credit on your trading account the residual value. And then I put on the cons, but sometimes can be also a pro, that there is no dividend distribution, because remember that the dividend has a positive impact on the financial level for long mini future and negative for short mini future. What about the platform? I showed you before, access from swissquote.com, selecting markets and quotes, then SwissDOTS on the left. The product is SwissDOTS, product type is 2210 mini futures. You will see this page. So SwissDOTS on the left. Mini future is the product. If you want to filter, so you can type underline security. If you want to select stop loss or long or short position only, you can do. How to place an order? We have this way to send the order. So you have the different information, the last price, the bid and the ask price. Remember that you can open only position in buy. So you can buy a long mini future, you can buy a short mini future. Then you select the quantity, the order type, limit, stop, OCO, or market. And in this case, the ask price is 3.05. I select 2.97. This is a limit order. And point number four, there is the validity of the order. Maybe you can select today or other different date. Above, you have the account. If you have a different account, maybe one in Swiss franc, one in euro, one in dollar, you have to select the account that you want from that drop-down menu. And then above, you have the information about the bid size, ask size, so liquidity in the market, displayed by the issuer, and the financing level and the stop loss level. Conclusion. So this is the third video of SwissDOTS. We talk about mini future. They have a variable leverage effect, volatility effect, there is no expiry, no maturity, it is an open-end contract, and there is a built-in stop-loss mechanism, so there is a premature loss in case this level will be hit. But please remember that you can open the position anytime, from 8 a.m. to 10 p.m. Central European time. You can close the position when the market is open, of course, but you can close by yourself. There is no expiry date. The issuer will close the position for you if the stop loss level will be hit. If not, you can keep the position open, or you can close when you want, selecting also take profits and so on. Okay. In the next video, we are going to talk about a certificate that they have a leverage, but is lower than knockout warrants or mini future. Mini future and knockout warrants are very similar products with leverage. You can select the leverage that you want according to the distance of the current underlying price and the strike price that you select. So you select the leverage that you want to use. And the difference between knockout warrants and mini future is that for knockout warrants, the stop loss level is equal to the strike price. For mini future, it is not the case. And for this reason, there is a residual value if the stop loss level will be touched. Okay? This is a maxi recap at the end of the presentation. For other webinars, do not hesitate to visit our webpage, swissquote.com/webinars. We have live webinars and on-demand webinars with a different recording, plus the some videos on YouTube. Remember that once of action is worth a ton of theory. A sentence that I really like, can appreciate. With us, you also have the opportunity to try our demo version. Anyway, visit SwissQuote.com if you want to use the demo or if you want to open a new live trading account. So thank you very much. If you need further information after this presentation, do not hesitate to drop me an email. This is my email address, stefano.gianti@swissquote.com. Or if you need some extra information about our services, contact us.